que no he hecho en mí.
Rasmi wajengo hili. Tungependa kuomba wakati mgeni wetu anaenda ndani, basi tusiende wote kwa sababu ya ile kuweza kuweka umbali wa mita moja, tuwacheze kuandamana na viongozi ambao viongozi wakuu, ili aweze kufika ndani na kujionea jinsi jengo hili limeweza kutengenezwa. Tayari amekisha kata utepe, tumpigie makofi tena.
Mgeni wetu
rasmi wa jengo hili. Tungependa kuomba wakati mgeni wetu anaenda ndani, basi tusiende wote kwa sababu ya ile kuweza kuweka umbali wa mita moja, tuwacheze kuandamana na viongozi ambao viongozi wakuu, ili aweze kufika ndani na kujionea jinsi jengo hili limeweza kutengenezwa. Tayari amekisha kata utepe, tumpigie makofi tena.
And as I said, every time I go to a police station, I do not miss an opportunity to even go to the canteen and see how our police officers are living, because we must demonstrate to our officers that we value them as professionals and as people who run towards danger when we run away from it ourselves. So I want our police officers to know that we really value you, and that's why we are doing this. Now, the second challenge, I reserve it for my fellow neighbors in Karen. Let us now do another big thing. Now we have done the canteen, now let us move to the next level. I have just spoken to the Director General Nema just now as I was here about this asbestos, and we have agreed that on Monday he will have a meeting with our Sector Internal Security, Mr. Njega, and they'll work on how we'll remove this asbestos from here. So because we don't endanger the lives of our police officers. And I'm told that some institutions around Karen have agreed to contribute so that we get, new mabatis and so on, and redo all these roofs so that we give our police officers a healthy working environment, as it were. I will also contribute as a neighbor to this project of giving our police officers new roofs and so on. I want to tell my chairman right now that as soon as he organizes us, whatever he requires of me, I'll make my contribution as a neighbor, and I'll mobilize other neighbors. I'll contribute towards pushing other neighbors to ensure that we give our police officers decent roofs and decent shelter here. The other thing that I think we now need to do, which is, I think the biggest thing we need to do, is work on a new housing infrastructure in this compound for the police. I will, within the next 10 days or so, come here with my friend Mr. Kiriwa, who is our new head of the PPP unit at the National Treasury, because we have just completed a new one PPP project for the police near State House, where we are going to construct ultra-modern facilities supported by private sector that will be used by the police, but some of it will be available, and through rent will recover those resources. I would like us to have the next PPP project for the police to be this current police station, because we have enough land and we have capability to team up with the PPP unit and the NMS to do something decent. So I will be back here again, Purity, in your compound with Mr. Kiriwa, so that we start working on that PPP proposal and interest private sector people to see how we can work with them. I was explaining to Dr. Aya and the others how that can be done, so that we end up giving our police officers very decent accommodation. Let us be very frank. I know, and I've been working on this with my colleagues, the IG and the others. Yes, we are giving police officers house allowance, but you know, depending on where the police officers are posted, I cannot imagine, for example, that even if we are giving police officers house allowance, they can afford to rent a house there and live here, because that house rent is 300,000, and that is not the rent, the house allowance for the police officers. It forces them to go and live in Bulbul or some other place up the road. So we could actually do decent two-bedroom stuff here, which they can rent at an affordable rent based on the house allowance they are getting. And we have a return on that investment. And at the end of it, because the land belongs to the government, we will now use it to get what we call economic rent in government, which is part of the income that will go to the police. And those who would have put money, the private sector people would have put money in doing the houses, would have gotten their return on investment and left after a period of time, and we can operate the houses. That is a win-win all round, because it will give our police officers decent houses. It will afford them very decent, working environment. And most importantly also, we will be indirectly making a long-term investment that will support other aspects of our security provisions in the country. Look, time is here for us to think differently. I mean, we cannot think the same way we have been thinking and hope that we will find solutions to some of our challenges at the moment. Let's think differently. Let's work on the issues we deal with, like in the security sector, differently from the way we have done. And I'm happy that because our president has led us in that direction of insisting on creative and very imaginative ways of finding solutions to our problems, we are breaking new grounds even in the security sector in terms of how we are going to accommodate our police officers. So I think our second PPP project for the police should be here in Karen. When that one comes up, the Nairobians and other, and as I said, thank you so much, colleagues, for supporting our police officers. I want to request each one of us, especially those of us who are not police officers, to be good ambassadors, to educate our people on the importance and the role of supporting our security people. I have just come from hospital where I went to see some of our officers who were injured some contact with criminals the other day. It's so difficult not to shed tears, when you see how those young boys are basically thrown everything about their life to the security of this country. The experiences they narrate to you, what they have gone through, and they are doing all that to protect us. While we are having our drinks here, driving up and down in Karen and enjoying our parties, and occasionally insulting the same police officers and talking about how they do nothing and how they are useless and so on, they are at the border. Because this team I went to see is our team at the border. They are at the border between us and Somalia. They are dealing with very dangerous criminals trying to keep all of us safe. Because if those mad people went past those officers and came here, they will cause us more problems. Fellow Kenyans, please let us change our attitude towards our security sector. And that's why I love all these good people, among us whom I live in Karen. Because you can see all of them, the attitude you see here in Karen, the attitude you see among us, all these neighbors of mine, is the kind of attitude you'd like to see in every part of our country, where people are positive, they know they have a role to play, they know they have a contribution to make, and they make it. They don't spend time just talking about it, criticizing purity. Oh, that woman there who's the OCS, we don't even know what she's doing and so on. You have no clue what she goes through. Many nights she doesn't sleep. While you are snoring there, drunk and, unable to even identify yourself, purity is awake to make sure that you can continue snoring and you can continue, all those things you are doing. So let's respect and our police officers and encourage them and work with them. They are not from heaven. They will have weaknesses or they will make mistakes, but that's fine. We also make mistakes in our various lives and we deal with each other and we correct the mistakes and move along. And let's not have this attitude of perpetually complaining and blaming, the police and doing nothing about it. Yet all these good people have given up their lives for our safety.